Okay, so now we've got our new board in Freeform, it's time to start adding some content. And what better place to start with than text? So at the bottom of my screen, I'm going to tap onto here, which is the text box icon. Frustratingly, it's put my text box right on top of my picture in the middle, but not to worry, I can simply drag it off, and then double tap to start typing. For my trip to Cologne, I want to have a nice selection of things I can look at for sightseeing, and also some things to buy as well. So let's label this text box Things to See, and then I'll make another one with that same button, and this one we'll call it Things to Buy. If I go back and tap on my first text box, I get this floating oval-shaped toolbar at the bottom. This is a really key part of Freeform, and it lets you adjust any item that you've selected. For example, from here I can change my font size, I can make it bold or italic, I can change the font itself, and start customising how this looks on my page. I can even change the colour as well. So let's go for a nice bright orange to set a theme for this board. Yeah, I think that looks great. Now rather than having to go onto my next title and do all of those different settings individually, if I tap onto the three dots on the original title, and then go onto the Style menu, I can select Copy Style. Then, on my next text box, I'm going to tap on it once to highlight it, press the three dots again, go onto Style, and press Paste Style. Just like that, all of the edits will be applied to this text box as well. As I mentioned earlier, we've got a large infinite canvas here, which means as I zoom out, I can simply tap and drag to move these text boxes around and position them on my board. Now let's start adding some things that I want to buy or shops that I want to visit in Cologne. And to do this, we'll use the sticky note button at the bottom. This differs from a text box in that they're all in one design, makes it really quick and simple to use. If I tap onto here, I can type in what I want to visit, perhaps the Apple store or the Lego store. I've now got some 3D looking sticky notes on my page. Now I can't change all of the properties of my font in these notes, but I can change the size of the text and I can change the colour of the sticky note itself, so I can make them stand out a little bit. Okay, in the next video, we're going to have a look at adding shapes onto our board and how to make them look really awesome. So follow the link and I'll see you there in a moment.